about a woman I met last year and the institution that she represents, the foundation. And I was touched. The first conversation we had brought about a lot of things to give meaning to what I'm seeing as opportunities in community. Other people say it's challenges. To me, I say it's opportunities. Opportunities that we, because challenges, if you look at issues and you say it's a challenge, you would never be able to challenge them because it's a challenge already. But if you look at them as an opportunity, it would give you that energy and it would give you that appetite to look at how do I make this opportunity a reality. So when I met her and we had discussions, I was touched by what she's doing in the foundation. And coming to that office, I have been exposed to schools in serious, serious conditions that need assistance. Because I come from this town called Ocho, and you can see buildings here is different from what you see up there in the most remote areas. How people suffer there is different from how us who have been given by government opportunities are taking them for granted. So you only appreciate when you see the conditions that people live in on the other side. And when I had a discussion with her, I learned that she's actually, I today want to say, you are not a partner to Kunene region, nor are you a stakeholder or somebody with an institution that's just doing corporate social responsibility. I want to officially declare you today as a sister of Kunene region. You are the sister of Kunene. You are our sister because you do not have when I should call you, what problems I should tell you, what I want to do. You accept all of them and you say, but what can we do together? So, Honorable Minister, Pupkewitz Foundation has been building classrooms, hostels, and they are building clinics in Kunene region, clinics as well. And how they are doing it is the contractor does community involvement, which I'm passionate about because it turns citizens into patriotic people towards a country, national service. So when you go there, communities are making the bricks. So the only things that you can see that are brought from far is this here. But bricks, the community makes them. So the community takes ownership of that building. They become patriotic. And I want to tell you, as young learners of Ocho, I want to tell you in front of my elders, my minister, the senior that I'm going to introduce now, opportunities are there for everybody, no matter where you come from, poor background, rich background, whether you come from informal settlement, whether you come from an underdeveloped town, opportunities are equal. Even if you go sleep on a hungry stomach, opportunities are equal. What turns opportunity in reality is you. You are the difference. If you accept where you come from, you accept where you find yourself, but you say status quo will not remain for the future, and you start working towards the future. At every occasion in Kunene region, there's a slogan that I say, step by step, shoulder by shoulder, we will collectively move Kunene region. And I want to tell you, the reason why is I come from Ocho, and I want to tell you people, Ocho people are spoiled. You have services here. You don't walk 10 kilometers to go to a school. You don't go and fetch water for 10 kilometers to first bath, cook, and then go to school. You don't sleep on the ground. You are being taught electricity is on. There are others that don't have that privilege. And that's why we are saying, step by step, we're going to take it step by step. We're not going to rush. We're not going to overcommit. We're going to take it step by step. The reason we are saying shoulder to shoulder is to say, if you want to blame government, stand there and blame. We will not listen to you because we have an opportunity and we will put our shoulders together, community, government, ministry, people, corporate industry, communities, and we shall collectively build this region called Kunene region. We are tired of complaints. We are tired of complaints. So, I want to urge you young people sitting there, you are the first to have such a very beautiful center in this region. You are the first. Let's not regret why Etosha Port is the first. Make use of this building. Ms. Vail, make use of this building. Etosha Port was one of the most weak performing secondary schools. And people were telling me a lot of things why it was happening. I said to the people, you are talking because you do not understand. We all have an opportunity that's equal. So if the learner is using his circumstances to determine his future for negativity, that's his own choice. So you learner sitting here, come next year, the results, we want to see better results. You do not have any excuse. We want to see better results. The minister is here of education, so don't make me promise on your behalf by lying. So I'm promising the minister to say, and the director as well, she included with me in the leadership, that honorable minister, we are going to better perform as Etosha Port. From one of those under to one of those on top. I do it on behalf of the learners in the region. Honorable Minister. That's it. I was telling you, the people of Pukiewicz, don't put me on the program because I might lose the role I have to play. But my apologies. My task today is very simple. Is to introduce a senior, to introduce a comrade, to me, an elder brother, because we are learning a lot from people like our honorable minister. Very experienced, tried and tested, has gone through a lot. And when I say a lot, learners, I want to tell you a lot, doesn't mean the minister is just somebody who was taken from the political party and made a minister. The minister has a background of international relations. He was an ambassador. An ambassador of Namibia to a very big country. I don't know whether you know that country. It's called United States of America. Now, the country said, we need your set skills. Please come and let's build the country together. So, it's our Minister of Presidential Affairs. So as I'm speaking today, it's my boss because I fall under the office of the president. So we report to him. It's my boss in the office of the president. And he's the acting Minister of Education. So please, let's rise, join me in welcoming Honorable Martin Anjaba to give the keynote address. Thank you very much.